Oklahoma, in the uncertain years just after World War I, was a place of harsh extremes, long bitter winters, and stifling hot summers. Yet for all its hardships, Oklahoma in the 20s was a place to grow and to dream. It was near the town of Kingfisher that Thomas Walton, a struggling young farmer, and his wife, Nancy Lee, started their family. And it was here that their son, Samuel Moore Walton, was born. Sam quickly learned the value of hard work and perseverance. And his curiosity was revealed early when, at the age of 3, he crept into the back row of a nearby schoolhouse and listened attentively to a half day of lessons. It was here, too, that Sam learned to hunt and occasionally joined his grandpa Lawrence on possum hunts. James Lawrence Walton, or Bud as he was known, was born almost 4 years after Sam, and they soon became great companions. In later years, their father recalled their mother's prayer that the sons would always remain close. It was his firm conviction that her prayers had been answered. As Sam approached school age, Thomas and Nancy Lee made a wise but, at the time, difficult decision. They sold all their personal property in a public sale, except for Sam's mare Trix, and moved to Springfield, Missouri. Here, Tom went into business with the Walton Mortgage Company as a farm loan appraiser. And it was here, and later in nearby Marshall, Missouri, that the Waltons felt their sons would receive a quality education. It wasn't long, however, before the storm clouds of a growing national depression began to gather. Thomas was transferred to Shelbina, Missouri, to assist in mortgage foreclosures, and Sam and Bud did what they could to help out. Sam milked the family's Jersey cow, and both boys found customers and delivered the milk. But heavy responsibilities at home did not keep Sam from pursuing his many other interests. And it was during this time, as the highest-ranking Boy Scout in Shelbina, that the 14-year-old Sam Walton rescued and, using his training, successfully resuscitated a boy who had gone down for the fifth time in the Salt River. Sam completed his freshman year at Shelbina, and in 1933, with the economy gradually improving, the family moved to Columbia, Missouri. Here, both Sam and Bud attended the David Henry Hickman High School. And it was here that the leadership ability of both boys became very apparent. As a halfback for the Hickman Cupies, Sam helped take his team to consecutive state championships in 1934 and 1935. And his basketball team became state tournament champions in 1936. Upon graduation, Sam had participated in nearly every high school organization. And as the student body president, Sam, as he was affectionately known by his classmates, capably delivered his graduating address on the topic of leadership. Following in Sam's footsteps, Bud also helped his school win the state basketball championship and served as class president in his senior year in 1939. Sam worked throughout his school career, earning his way by delivering the local newspaper. After finishing high school, he went on to the University of Missouri in Columbia, where he graduated with a major in economics. He pledged Beta Theta Pi fraternity and was quoted in their chapter's publication as one of those rare people who knows every janitor by name, passes plates in church, and loves to join organizations. Bud chose to attend Wentworth Military Academy in Lexington, Missouri. But upon graduation, both Sam and Bud started their careers in retailing with the J.C. Penney Company in Iowa, Sam in Des Moines, and Bud in Cedar Rapids. Earning $85 a month, Sam would use his lunch breaks to comparison shop at other stores, a practice he continued at Walmart. World War II, though, would put a temporary end to retailing. Sam served as a captain in the Army Intelligence Corps from 1942 to 1945, moving 16 times during his tenure. Bud became a naval aviator, flying many combat missions from a carrier in the South Pacific. It was after Sam was on active duty that he married Helen Robson of Claremore, Oklahoma, the daughter of Hazel and L.S. Robson, a prominent lawyer, rancher, and banker. Sam first saw Helen when both were students in Columbia. She was on the swim team at Christian College, and he had been a referee at one of her meets. She and Sam renewed acquaintances when, quite by chance, he spotted her again, a couple years later, at a Claremore bowling alley. Snowy, Utah was the last of their many army moves, but only one chapter in this lifelong love affair. Sam has always been quick to credit Helen's dedicated support and companionship to his success with Walmart. Sam and Helen have lived in Bentonville since 1950, and there they have raised their four children, Jim, Rob, John, and Alice. It was really Helen who persuaded Sam to settle in a small town, citing the quality of life and the importance of community and small town values. And it was due in large part to Helen and her tireless involvement in school, civic, and church activities that the guiding values of Walmart also centered about the community and family. Sam tries to encourage the same values in his Walmart associates.
I personally would like to see many of our people settle down in Walmarts like Bentonville, Arkansas, for instance, or Neosho, Missouri.
They'd be fortunate.
Or Fayetteville, Arkansas, and plant their roots and become members of the Chamber of Commerce and become the church of their choice, the Rotary Club, and get their home paid for and become leaders in their community.
Sam and Helen's family has always included the growing family of Walmart associates. And throughout his career, Sam has personally made it his trademark to visit as many associates as he could, traveling to stores on a frequent and regular basis. The partnerships that Sam and his family have created are based on common values: love of home, love of family, and a genuine concern for others. Perhaps Thomas Walton said it best: Walmart has leaders with love for their fellow man. The partnership that created the legacy of Walmart endures nearly 50 years after Sam and Helen first met. And it's a partnership that continues to shape the values of a company known as Walmart.